Again, you're watching Sky News now. A lot of you, if you look at that, immediately you'll think, oh, another 400 steps to my goal, won't you? I'm sure you will. But could your exercise app actually be doing you more harm than good? A leading US scientist has warned the devices don't push people to chase ambitious individual goals and that many aren't based on scientific evidence. Talk about it in more detail. Joining us now is men's fitness writer and personal trainer Scott Laidler. Hi, Scott.
Hiya.
10,000 steps a day. Good idea, bad idea?
Well, it's always a good idea to have a goal to work towards. 10,000 steps is a little bit arbitrary. It's based on a Japanese study from 1960. But in our modern time, we tend to say, for example, 10,000 steps per day would be about 500 calories per day. Over the week, that would be 3,500, and you'd drop about a pound of fat doing that 10,000. So that's why.
It's not a lot, is it?
It's not a lot, but if it's pure fat, that makes a big difference.
Okay, so if you can't do 10,000 steps a day, either because you can't walk that far for whatever reason, or you just don't have the time. I know you're going to say if you've got time to sleep, you've got time to exercise. But if you can't, what should you be doing?
Well, there are certain populations that 10,000 steps would be too much. Potentially the elderly or anybody who was recovering from sort of a disease or an illness, that could be too much. But you can get a good workout in 4 minutes. You can get a good workout in an interval training protocol, which is called Tabata. You can get good workouts in 10 to 20 minutes of resistance training. You can get an express yoga workout in 30 minutes. So it doesn't have to be an arbitrary 10,000 steps from walking.
Okay. Easier said than done, isn't it? It's about motivation. I always find the most challenging bit about running for me is putting my trainers on. It's about motivating yourself. How do you get to do that?
It's all habit forming. It's just, you're not going to want to do 10,000 steps on day one. You may start with 1,000 steps, then two, and build up. But it's just about making sure that you're willing to pay the price to get to the goal that you want to achieve, and just building on that day after day. And that's how you build self-esteem, and that's how you build momentum in fitness.
Got quite a good figure there. What do you actually do? What exercise do you take?
For me personally, I'll do 2 to 3 weights workouts a week. I will walk 2 to 3 times a week, and I'll do yoga 2 to 3 times a week as well.
So how many hours does that take up?
All in all, about 10 to 12 hours of exercise.
That's a lot, though. I mean, people watching this afternoon will say, I haven't got 10 to 12 hours of time to exercise.
I think people will find, especially with walking, that they'll be walking more than they account for.
Are there little things that you can do, though?
Yeah, I mean, things like walking, you can build walking into your everyday routine, you can walk to tube stations, you can get off early at the bus and things like that. But it doesn't have to be these 10,000 steps. That's about 90 minutes of walking per day. You can say to yourself, okay, I'm going to do 6 minutes in the morning, just a little bit of a mobility routine, just a little bit of bodyweight training, squats and lunges and press-ups and planks, and that's enough. It's just as long as you're active. And that's why some of these wearable devices, they do give you a little bit of a hint every now and then. They say you've been inactive for too long and you need to do some activity. That can be walking or that can be body weight.
And you were telling me that you can actually, I don't know how Ali's going to feel about this, but we're going to use the desk to use our own body weight to do some press-ups. How does that sound?
Okay.
Show me how to do it.
Yeah.
I think I know, but I'll do it anyway. So I just need to lean here, don't I?
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. From here, making sure your hips don't drop down or rise up too high and just keep your elbows in. Push down like that.
Okay.
And then back up again.
Okay.
Nice
and it's really important to do this slow as well.
Really slow, yes. Yeah. So about 2 seconds on the way down.
Okay.
And 2 seconds on the way up.
Okay. And this is really easy to do. So you don't actually need to get weights, do you, to do this sort of stuff at home? You can do it on the kitchen counter or whatever.
Yeah, the body weight provides an excellent workout, and you can take that to really advanced stages as well.
Okay, you know I've got to do another 90 minutes of telly after this,
okay.
Which is really easy for you. So as you were saying, you did what, 10 or 12 hours a week?
About that, yeah.
Okay.
But that's my profession, so I would do a little bit more. But to stay healthy...
It's finished and I'm still going, I'm just saying.
To stay healthy, you can do maybe 3 or 4 hours a day.
Come on,
a week. You go, well, we can do this. And another one you can do is you can turn around and you can go for tricep dips.
Yeah, I know this one as well. But you can't do that. Hold on. I need to take my heels off.
Yep.
There we go. So like this?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, elbows nice and tight. And then 2 seconds down, 2 seconds up. If this was a little bit lower, you can put your leg on it as well and you can get lunges in. You can step up to it, but it's a little bit high for that.
Okay.
But it just goes to show you only need your own body weight to get a great workout.
Okay. I better put my shoes back on.
Okay.
Okay, so, and diet is important as well, finally.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
Okay.
Diet is potentially more important than exercise. I mean, in fitness, we really consider walking activity rather than exercise, and it's just something that we should all do just as human beings to keep our body functional. But nutrition is probably 70% of the picture. So you can't really exercise your way out of a poor diet. So that has to be at the paramount of any health and fitness.
And as you get older, it's important to do strength work?
Yeah, certainly. So as you get older, you need to do strength work to maintain your muscle mass because that tends to decline with age, also to offset things like osteoporosis. But as you get older, you need to be a little bit more careful with recovery. Your body just doesn't recover as fast as it used to in the 20s and 30s. Doesn't mean to say you can't do similar workouts and push really hard, but you just have to be a little bit more aware of recovery.
And a final thought, I was reading in the Times, I think at the weekend, saying that men in their 40s need to not over-exercise.
Yeah, for that reason, yeah. So the hormones are a little bit lower.
Out of time.
Hormones a little bit lower and just takes longer to recover.
Great to talk to you. We'll see you at 5 o'clock. Bye-bye for now.